The air station here in Yuma is very significant to the U.S., and particularly the Marine Corps, but the U.S. in general, because we have sort of a combination of three things. We have the weather, we have the ranges very centrally located that where you can do any sort of training that's needed, and we have the access to ordnance. Our sort of claim to fame here really is the ranges, and so we're the busiest Marine Corps air station in the world. Now that's not saying a heck of a lot because there's only nine, but we're also the third busiest base in the Department of the Navy, and that is saying a lot because there's a number of those. And the statistics are that we are about a $2.1 billion a year industry in the Yuma area. Now that makes us second, to agriculture, which of course in Yuma is king. We're in the southeastern portion of the city. The city continues to grow, in some cases growing around us, but we're very uniquely suited, situated, because of our location with relation to the training ranges that we have available to us here in Yuma, in southwestern Arizona.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Splash.
We have the Barium Goldwater Range, which is just to our east, and to our east, I mean about 4 miles to our east. And that Barium Goldwater, when you have the length and breadth of it, stretches all the way from I-8 in the north to the Mexican border in the south, and from all the way from Yuma at the Colorado River to Tucson. So it's a huge range, a huge training range that's really unavailable anywhere else in the world. Additionally, we have the Chocolate Mountain Gunnery Range, which is what I think, and others would say the same, is it's really a national treasure. It's a jewel, if you will, that there is no other place in the world anymore, certainly that I know of. But it's a bombing range that we have in Southern California, north of the Salton Sea, that's been there since about 1942 when it was sort of outlined back then. But the Chocolate Mountain Area Gunnery Range is the place where you can launch, fire, release, drop, shoot, just about anything that an airplane or a helicopter can shoot, launch, release, or fire. It's a great place because nowhere on the East Coast is that available, and it's one of the reasons that Yuma is what it is, although we're home to MOTS and the air group MAG 13, we're primarily a training base. MOTS 1 is MOTS stands for Marine Aviation Weapons and Tactics School, and you can sort of equate it to Top Gun, if you will. It's sort of the Top Gun of the Marine Corps. It's a train-the-trainer sort of program. So they take very qualified people out of the fleet and train them to the latest standard in tactics and techniques and procedures, and then send them back out to the fleet in order to teach those same things to their fleet squadrons. Our major tenant on the base are the Harrier squadrons. Four of the eight Harrier squadrons in the Marine Corps are based here in Yuma. The Harrier itself is the Marine Corps' sort of premier light attack platform that we use for all over the world, and as a matter of fact, a very capable airplane that most people recognize as being that airplane that can take off and land vertically. So instead of needing large runways and very large and prepared airfields like we have here, for example, it can operate out of very short fields, roads, small decks of ships, things like that. Many people don't realize that the Harriers have been here in Yuma since about 1971, and they've been here for a very, very long time. So in 1942, Yuma Army Airfield was established, and that's when this air base was laid out and some of the buildings were put up. The building you're in now, as a matter of fact, is one of the last remnants of the Yuma Army Airfield that was here in 42 through 45. And oddly enough, there was mostly tents and temporary buildings and everything else, but they trained gunners and they trained air crewmen and things like that for B-17s and B-24s here in Yuma. After the war, the air base shut down, as many of them did. Yuma had an event take place in 49. So the city of Yuma put on an endurance flight that set a world record, and it was done in order to draw the attention of the Department of Defense, or back then it was probably still the War Department, to the good weather and the good fly-in weather down here in Yuma in order to reopen the base. And oddly enough, it worked. So they so two fellas got in an airplane and flew it around literally for 49 days without landing right here in the local area. And it did draw the attention of the Air Force. And they reopened the base in the early 50s as Vincent Air Force Base. When Vincent closed, it was given to the Navy. The Navy never opened it as a naval base, but they gave it right to the Marine Corps. And we opened as Marine Corps Air Station back in 1962. So in 62, we became the air station. We just celebrated our 50th anniversary as an air station last July. And since then, you know, we've done nothing but grow as a deployment base, which is what our primary mission is now. We sent the first squadron overseas following the September 11th attacks. So VMA 513 moved into Bagram Airfield and stayed for a year, beginning in July or June or so of 2002. You know, the entire air group deployed for Operation Iraqi Freedom back in March of 2003, starting probably in December or so in January of 2003, so that they were there. And some were ship-based, some were land-based, but in effect, the entire air base or the entire air group and all of its attachments all left here in, to be part of Iraqi Freedom. The F-35 is the sort of the future of, well, it's not even sort of the future, it is the future of marine aviation, of America's strike force, if you will. It's military aircraft, fixed-wing military aircraft, is moving to an F-35-based force. So the Marines, as a matter of fact, will replace all of her Harriers, all of its F-18s, and all of its EA-6B Prowlers eventually. With the F-35. I don't want to call it like the Harrier, but it's Harrier-like in that it has the ability to do vertical landings and short takeoffs and operate from short fields and things like this. It's the biggest defense program, I think, in the history of defense programs. And it's exciting for us particularly because Yuma is the home of the first of the operational F-35 squadron. The F-35 first arrived here in Yuma last November. And we stood up the squadron. It's VMFA 121. They gain airplanes every month, and they continue to train pilots. But F-35 is very important. It's bringing a lot of freshness, if you will. So with that new aircraft, brought some military construction to Yuma that helped us to update the systems and the infrastructure that we have on the base. That was very much needed. And you know, if you think the base was actually laid down in 1950s with Vincent Air Force Base, as I mentioned, you know, much of that infrastructure remained and is now only recently being updated. And so it's good. It's good for us. It's good for the city. And I think it'll be good for Marine Aviation for the next 50 years if that's what they decide they want us to do.